So I just, the GoPro just shut off and said repairing file. So I think it repaired it, but just in case it didn't, good morning and happy Labor Day. We are leaving the Lily Lake Primitive Campground area. It was awesome. We're gonna drive up to the Steen Mountain Overlooks. It was so quiet here last night. It was amazing. The stars were just unbelievable. But I was the only one here. I thought maybe someone was in these lower campgrounds, but nope. So the lake, I'm wondering if the lake is dried up. Oh, there is some water there and some lilies. Not much water though, it's pretty small. I had like 2 flies bothering me and that was it. Oh, and a couple bees for like 5 minutes. Other than that, there were no bugs. I don't know where the flies came from. But, this section is, I gotta be careful. Some big rocks. But yeah, so I'm so far south. The sunrise is 7 a.m. and the sunset at 7 p.m. It's 7:20 right now. But I added this campsite to Google Maps. Should be up soon. That's why people weren't staying here, I think. Because one, the sign is past the entrance. And then it's not on Google Maps. It's not on any of the mapping applications I have for some reason. It's really nice. But I think we'll eat some breakfast once we get to the top, the first overlook. Oh, these washboards. Ah, this is a bad section. Oh, I'm going like 5 miles an hour. 5 miles an hour. Yeah, I imagine Lily Lake has a lot more water in the early spring. Oh yeah, it's probably 20% of its normal size. So the next campground down the road, we'll drive through it. It has a lake. Ah, the sun is bright. I didn't think about that. I almost got up an hour ago so I could get to the overlook by the sunrise. But it's hazy, I think, still. I just didn't want to. I didn't think it was worth it. Oh my gosh. Yeah, this is the worst section of road so far. Maybe worse than the beginning. Definitely did not get as cold. Had all my blankets. I shut all the flies. Oh wow, and it's 42 degrees, the truck says. So that's impressive. This tent is very warm when you shut everything and have, you know, proper blankets and stuff or sleeping bags. I just looked at the truck temperature. I can't believe that. I mean, that is cold. Coldest night I've had so far. So maybe I just need one sleeping bag, you know, for when it gets down to 32. And that sleeping bag will be enough, you know, with my blankets. Road's getting a little better. You got a speed demon behind me too. Mm-hmm. much better. It's Fish Lake. Yeah, it's a fee area. So Fish Lake Recreation Site. We'll check it out. $8. Huh. The reviews were saying it was marshy on this end. I don't see any marsh. Not on that first campsite, at least. First campsite looked nice. Hoping it's a loop road. But we will find out. Oh, I think this goes to the back side of the lake where the camp there's other campgrounds. A lot of chipmunks. So I think on the western side of the lake, people were saying there's no trees when you camp, and there were less bugs. The road is nice so far. Yeah, you can't beat these free or $8 or $4 a night campsites, though. Love it. Oh, there's the lake. It is big. Wow. It's got a lot of water in it. It's got a ton of water in it. So the Steen Mountains are the largest fault block mountains in North America, I think I saw when I was reading about it. It's pretty incredible, I guess. So I guess that means it's from faults moving. Oh, there's tent camping down the road I just passed. We will skip that. I thought this was all tent camping, though. Oh, yeah, this is definitely out of the trees. Spot on my right is pretty neat. Spot 13. And there's a road that goes off somewhere. I have no idea where. Probably one of these dead-end roads. Get you in trouble. Yeah, this is pretty nice over here. If you don't want to camp alone and, you know, pay a minimal fee. Oh, wow. Spot 6, and you're right by the lake. Got a picnic table. That is nice. yeah, this is, I would definitely camp here if I came back. Check it out. Definitely recommend Fish Lake Campground. Let's go look at the other half of the campground on the eastern side of the lake. I wonder if the tent camping is more for hikers or bikers. I don't know. Maybe you walk your, you have to walk to your tent site. I will be happy when I get better tires for this truck. I mean, these tires are fine, but I want the heavy-duty off-road tires that are less resistant to punctures and stuff. And I wonder if they would feel smoother on these roads, too, because they have way bigger tread and everything. But that'll probably be it in a couple years. Wear these tires out, 2 or 3 years. They're not that much more than these either. Oh, there's a deer crossing the road. I think the guy said $250 each, which is what I paid for the RV tires. Wow. Oh, there he is. He's looking at me. If I didn't have the GoPro on fixed to the dash, I would take it off and get a shot. I need to get a second GoPro. I want to get the Hero 9 Black. Maybe I'll do that this winter or next spring for sure. Then I'll have two GoPros, like one on the dash and one I can move around with my hands. Alright, let's check out the camping boat launch area. So you can have boats on the lake, they just can't have motors. I guess there's fish in it, surprisingly, like carp or something, probably. I don't know, unless they stock it with trout or something. That's possible. Yeah, I think I'll just stop this video here, and we'll just make this a Fish Lake video. Wow, there's some big campsites here. There's a lot of campsites here. So I wonder if this road might just go to the boat launch. Yep, so we are gonna turn around here. Or wait, does it? Yeah, I think this is the end of the road. Get out. Get some video. Well, we just got back from checking out Fish Lake, and we're gonna finish driving through the Fish Lake campground and head on up the road. Definitely more people here, and the sound carries on that lake. I can hear people talking at the campsites in either direction. Definitely like my campsite. I can see where there'd be more bugs here though, because you are pretty close to the lake. Especially if you're in these spots right on my right. You're pretty much on the lake. That might be why no one's taking them. Yeah, it is pretty marshy right here. Wow. I would not recommend staying on the west or the east side of Fish Lake, just like the reviews said. Definitely check out the western side. You have better views too of the lake and the surrounding area. Way better. Not impressed with the eastern side. I imagine in the early summer or wet years, it's even worse. Wow, this must be their pump house. Yep. So you can get away from the lake. Some of these spots don't look as bad, but I imagine the bugs, it's not too far for them to fly. And this is a dead end. Weird. It's always fun backing up on these roads. Oh, I could have pulled in there and backed up. I didn't think of that. That's all right. I'll do it the fun way. So I was thinking last night after backing up on that kind of sketchy dead-end road in my campground, it would not be very fun to have even a little trailer and get stuck on a road like that. It would have been hard to back up. So it's definitely nice not having any trailer for these roads. Yeah, these spots don't look too bad. Oh my god, full of trash and wood. I guess people figured they brought all their crap and then saw they couldn't have fires. Oh, these are the same bushes that try and grow in our field at home. I hate them. I wish I knew what they were. Nothing good, I will say that. Oh, jeez. I don't know where those bumps came from. Well, we're gonna end this video once we get to the road. That was Fish Lake Campground. $8 a night. Vault toilets, picnic table. Fire rings for when there's no fire ban. So there's this one campsite right by the entrance, which is kind of weird. I mean, it's super quiet, but you're not by the bathroom or nothing. I kind of like it though, for me. Like, but thanks for watching. Lily Lake Campground to Fish Lake Campground.